SpaceX's insane portable nuclear reactor. Do you think that each household can have a small nuclear power plant that would eliminate shortages of electricity? Well, believe it or not, there is a group of people who are already thinking ahead and are already planning on building one. A group of ex-SpaceX engineers is planning to build a portable nuclear reactor. They want to build nuclear reactors that can be transported anywhere where needed be. More so, they claim that it will be powerful enough to provide enough electricity to power about 1,000 American homes. But what we're all wondering is, will they be able to achieve this? Hello and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we check out the insane portable nuclear reactor that ex-SpaceX engineers have planned. Remember to like the video and subscribe to our channel for more amazing videos. And with that said, let's find out what plans these engineers have for the portable nuclear reactor. SpaceX is all about thinking outside the box. They have achieved so much, disrupting the whole space industry. Not only this, but all of Elon Musk's companies always shake up the industries that they are in. Because of this, they attract the best of the best. They have managed to take on top contracts in the space sector, building one of the most powerful rockets, manufacturing and selling the best electric cars there are, and even providing internet to the whole world using satellites. This was all achieved by Musk and his employees, and they are not stopping. However, the spirit of innovation and having unique ideas and designs does not leave the employees even after they leave. Take, for example, Lucid Motors, which is currently run by a former Tesla design chief, J.B. Straubel, who was co-founder of Tesla, started a company that recycles battery materials, Redwood Materials. Will Bruey went from working on SpaceX's Dragon capsules to buying rideshare rocket launchers from SpaceX with the aim of putting an industrial park in space for his company, Varda. Of all of the employees who have left SpaceX and built something else, we cannot forget the founder of Radiant. This is the company that is behind the whole idea of a portable nuclear reactor. Its founder and CEO, Doug Bernier, was in charge of developing energy sources that would work on Mars when he was at SpaceX. This was in accordance with Musk's life ambition to build a colony on Mars. While Bernier was working at SpaceX, he was helping with the development of nuclear reactors that would be used to provide power to run a life-sustainable system on Mars. However, Bernier realized that nuclear reactors would not only be useful on Mars, but also here on Earth. This led him to open his own company with his colleagues. For their startup, Radiant, to help develop its portable nuclear micro-reactors, they managed to raise a total of $1.2 million from angel investors last year. But what kind of reactor are they making? We have previously heard of floating nuclear power stations, like those by the Danish firm Seaborg Technology. Nonetheless, Radiant has promised something that brings a completely new dimension of portability to the nuclear reactor. Their micro-reactor is said to be the size of a shipping container. This makes it even more portable than ever. Radiant aims at making these micro-reactors very affordable and reliable power sources. Bernier's inspiration came from the fact that there are no portable nuclear reactors on the market yet. In an interview with Power, he said, "A lot of the micro-reactors being developed are fixed locations. Nobody has a commercial system yet, so there's kind of a race to be the first." So how does this micro-reactor work? All nuclear reactors work by following the same principles. The only thing that differs is the material used. For example, most nuclear reactors use high-pressured water for cooling, but Radiant uses helium. According to Radiant, this change in materials makes a very big difference in reducing corrosion, boiling, and contamination risks. The fact that Radiant's micro-reactor's particle fuel does not melt is also a great difference from other nuclear reactors. This makes it easier to deal with the waste, since solid radioactive substances are easier to deal with than vaporized one. In turn, this reduces safety hazards. Another benefit is that they can handle higher temperatures than traditional nuclear fuels. Radiant is currently trying to find a way to refuel the reactors and also transport the heat out of the reactor core. The micro-reactor, which will be the size of a shipping container, is said to produce at least 1 megawatt of electricity. Radiant claims that this will be enough power to power approximately 1,000 homes. As if that is not enough, they claim that it can go to up to 8 years without the need of refueling. we can say that the company has made progress in its quest. Raytheon announced that it has received two provisional patents for its portable nuclear reactor. One of them was for a technology that reduces the cost and the time needed to refuel the reactor, while the other one improves efficiency and heat transference from the reactor core. Other companies in the industry are noticing what Raytheon is doing and they want to be part of it. One of them is Battelle Energy Alliance, BEA. They signed a test contract with Raytheon to test out its portable microreactor technology at its Idaho National Laboratory, INL. Brunei hinted that the microreactors can be operated from quite a distance. However, in all this, what are the benefits of a microreactor like the one being built by Raytheon? For starters, they are quite small, the size of a shipping container, and they can therefore be moved anywhere where they are needed. This includes areas where other forms of energy production may not be practical. These areas include places where there is no wind or sun to produce energy. These microreactors can even be used underground. Another benefit is that they can be moved around during or after natural disasters, especially those that cause massive power outages and/or blackouts. However, they are not only useful in such situations, but also in those where the area is too remote to receive power direct from the grid. They are logically more convenient to use in remote areas because, unlike diesel-powered generators, these microreactors do not need to be refueled as often. In places where the power from the grid is available, these microreactors can also be useful in balancing the load during times when power is in high demand, like in summer. In addition, microreactors can also be used in distributed energy systems. Nuclear reactors are bound to pollute the environment heavily, and environmental activists have always been against this. However, this might be the solution, as these microreactors do not produce emissions of any kind. In return, all diesel generators that produce harmful fumes would eventually be done away with, and in turn, all the emissions that would be produced during the transportation of diesel all around the world would be done away with. This would make for a greener, cleaner environment. Unlike nuclear reactor sites, microreactors are much easier to build and secure. Because of the choice of materials, microreactors tend to be safer than nuclear power plants by a large margin. Not only this, but compared to nuclear power plants, they obviously cost far less to acquire and commission. Furthermore, these microreactors can be placed in countries where it proves difficult to build a nuclear plant altogether. Not only can these microreactors be used to power up homes, but they have military use too. Bernier said that one of his main targets is the Department of Defense. Lucky for them, the DoD is actually looking for a way to produce power in remote areas where there is no power supply without using diesel and other fuels to do so. If you have a look at the US Army, they spend a lot on transporting fuel in order to power up their generators in remote places. This also exposes their personnel to more attacks, in addition to costing them money and time. However, with the Raytheon microreactors, the Army would significantly reduce the time it spends on the road transporting fuel. The microreactors would also help, given that they can be moved around easily. In addition to being easily transportable, the Army, alongside every other place that would use these microreactors, would benefit from the ease and speed with which they can be set up. Bernier's aim is a maximum of 72 hours from the time it is set down on site to full power production capacity. He also said that they are using fuels that the Department of Energy has already tested and approved. What attracts the investors to Raytheon is the startup team's aerospace background and engineering talent. One of the investors actually said, "The innovative and ambitious team of Raytheon has expertise from SpaceX as well as impressive nuclear industry credentials. They have what it takes to bring new clean energy to the market, and I'm excited to be part of their journey." Bernier goes ahead to point out one more thing that sets them apart from other microreactor developers. His engineers have made actual engineering products, unlike others who have academic backgrounds. Even with all this, Raytheon is not the only company that is working on building microreactors. NASA is working on one, and it is said that it is way smaller than the size of a garbage can. Seaborg Technologies have also raised funds to begin construction of its own nuclear reactor called the Compact Molten Salt Reactor. And unlike Raytheon, Seaborg plans to form offshore power plants. Even with all these companies building microreactors, Raytheon seems to be the first to have an actual product. This is given the nature of the engineers working there and the determination that the ex-SpaceX engineers have. What do you think of Radiant's microreactors? What do you think they should try to do differently? Let us know in the comments section below. Remember to leave a like, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell button to get notified of our new videos. Until next time, bye.